All right, I just got done with my pauper two-man. We won a pack, so yay. So our hand was the Temple of Mystery, and then this minus the Forest. And that's a cavalry Pegasus, which means I think we are going to be hard casting. We are going to be casting Leap-Crowned Ride as a creature, which I'm completely okay with. We drew Nylea's Emissary, which is nice. It fits the curve pretty well. We are playing against white blue, which generally has a lot of heroic if it's playing cavalry Pegasus. We're gonna remove. And the Leaf Crown Dryad is more to aqueous forming my Leaf Crown Dryad. I think he misclicked. This is super awkward now. Although he gets to scry whenever I attack, and now he has an Ordeal of Heliod on it. So that's super awk. I mean, that's actually kind of good if we wanted to get aggressive with our creature. He can no longer really attack effectively with it. And our Leaf Crown Dryad is unblockable. So we're just going to play this land out. And we're not going to do anything yet. We can't time defeat efficiently. I mean, we could probably get in for one damage. I mean, that would allow him to scry. This is it's a weird situation to be in, I'll be honest. Yeah, we're gonna attack. That's so weird. You're welcome. I want to get rid of this aqueous form now. And he put the scryed card on top. This Leap Crown Dryad is going to be pretty important when it comes to the humans that he's going to be playing next. So, all right, Wave Crash Triton. That's obnoxious. It's probably going to be eating a time to feed. And with Wave Crash Triton, I'd rather play Nylea's Emissary as a creature because, or ooh, nope, just kidding, can't do that. Because he can lock down more of our creatures that way. It's harder for him to lock down all of our creatures, is what I meant to say. And I'm guessing he has a God's Willing, which is why he's holding up the white. In Theros Draft, if you're playing white, it's generally very good practice to hold up one white mana if you have the option. So we're winning this race so far. Pretty good. Alright, Voyaging Satyr, also pretty good. It allows us to play, for example, Time to Feed and Voyaging Satyr if we wanted. I think we're just going to attack with the Leaf Crown Dryad, though. We could attack with the Nylea's Emissary, but I'd rather we did not walk straight into something that buffs the Wave Crash Triton so much. No blocks? Oh, wow. Sea God's Revenge, Jeepers Creepers. Okay, so fortunately for us, that gives us a chance to, well, first of all, it doesn't really do anything. He put a card on the bottom. It allows him to survive a little bit longer. Okay, so we have a couple of options. We can either spit out our hand again, and by spit out, I mean play like two of these things, or we can play Shipbreaker Kraken, and I think that is the plan here. Because Shipbreaker Kraken, next turn we can cast Time to Feed and something else potentially. We still Leaf Crown Dryad or something. We will be assembling more time. He does have some bounce, so. What's wrong with your computer? I feel really bad for this guy. And yeah, I wouldn't be. Maybe. So apparently he's very sleep deprived. That's super awkward for me. It's just really awkward. Yeah, I'm assuming he was aiming for the Wave Crash Triton, but got confused by their similar colors. Alright, so he's using Fate Foretold to tap down the Shipwrecker Kraken, or Shipbreaker Kraken rather. And this means, I'm assuming that this means that he doesn't have anything. Oh, okay. He definitely doesn't have anything else. Which means that we can use this lovely Time to Feed to get rid of that nuisance. And he does draw a card, which is a bit unfortunate. But I gained 3 life, so there. And I think what we're going to do is. We have enough mana to monsters next turn, don't we? So we're just going to bestow Leaf Crown Dryad. We can't block, but we're only taking two, so I'd say we're winning that particular race. And we can either Monstrous or bestow Nylia's Emissary. I guess he's not planning on blocking, so. Or maybe he has a bounce spell. Which makes me think that since Monstrous-ing it and bestowing Nylia's Emissary don't affect the clock at all, it'll still take two turns to kill him. I think the best thing to do would just be to attack with Shipbreaker Kraken. And that way if he has bounce, we're not as affected by it. And affecting the clock means that it will change the number of turns that it takes, yeah, see, Divine Verdict. It takes to win the game. And in this case, he's at 14, and we have 7 mana available, and we have a 2 power creature. So it's gonna take us 2 turns of attacking minimum. We could play Nessian Asp, and we could play like Voyaging Satyr, and plan on monstrousing Nessian Asp next turn. But I don't want to really show him the Nessian Asp yet, so I think we're just gonna play Prescient Chimera and the Voyaging Satyr, and then bestow Nylia's Emissary, and it will be a similar clock because of Leaf Crown Dryad. Additionally, this prevents him. Well, this It would have prevented him from attacking with the cavalry Pegasus anyway, but the chosen cavalry Pegasus. Alright, so there's another prescient chimera. We're gonna bestow here. And we're going to attack. I can't really attack with this leaf ground dryad. I can't justify it. So it might have been better to play the Nessian Asp. In fact, I'm pretty sure it was better. But I wouldn't want to show him too much of my deck, especially considering we're pretty far ahead right now. And we definitely have more win conditions than just Shipbreaker Kraken. So he's being blocked by one, which is kind of silly because it has trample. So I think he's realizing this. I wish I had combat tricks. Alright, so yeah, I could have played Nessian Courser, or Nessian Asp, rather. I'm gonna play Nessian Courser here, because that way we can attack with all of our guys. Okay, so he's just absorbing four here. Maybe he's doing something tricksy with like Triton Tactics or something. Or Battlewise Valor. Dauntless Onslaught. Triton Tactics, here we go. So, Prescient Chimera doesn't untap during my next untap step. Which means that I kill one of the Cavalry Pegasi. But I don't kill both of them. So I'm going to play this Nessian Asp. And I'm also going to play this Nessian Courser. So that I can definitely try and kill him next turn. Alright, so he just concedes. Cool. Had all these, brother. I think we just run it back. We could play a null. We could to save him the embarrassment of accidentally casting one of our things. Yeah, we'll keep this. It's pretty solid. It's got lands, it's got spells, and we're on the draw, so we can certainly draw, for example, a Voyaging Satyr with reasonable swiftness. Or a land. Land works too. And we're going to run out the Nessian Courser first, because the Nessian Courser will block things more readily, I believe. Alright, so, Cavalry Pegasus. He does not have... Oh, he does. Okay. Good. I was going to get embarrassed if he, like, Chosen of Heliod-ed my Nessian Courser to draw land. Nessian Courser is like a more solid creature, whereas something like, okay, you have an Aqueous Worm, which is actually kind of a problem, because if he has creatures, it's going to be a lot harder to get rid of the Cavalry Pegasus. The Agent of Horizons is much better if you have some sort of Voltron going on. And I'd rather have Nessian Courser eat removal. Alternatively, Agent of Horizons is something that could bait out a Divine Verdict before I actually play my Shipbreaker Kraken. Lands on lands. I think what I'm going to do this turn is cast the Burnish Chart. I don't really mind using a turn to break it, and then I can, if I draw a Voyaging Sate or something, play that too. Okay. And where does his scry go? Aqueous Form is a deceptively powerful spell because allowing, putting on the bottom, okay. The scry each turn, especially, the free scry each turn essentially, allows you to, sift through your deck to find something, a reasonable answer. Alright, Sealock Monster. So that Sealock Monster can actually attack us. Okay, so because it can attack, I am going to hold back Burnished Heart, and Burnished Heart's going to block and then sacrifice itself for the greater good here. Alright, chosen by Heliod. Still gets locked down by a Shipbreaker Kraken though. We can play a land next turn, and then we'll have 8, which is pretty good. Alright, so only the Pegasus is attacking, which is fine. And he... put a card on the bottom. Okay. Theros gonna get an island, and we're gonna get a forest. Nessie and Asp, that's a big boy. Okay, so here I have a couple of options. I could play Karametra's Acolyte and Agent of Horizons, or I could play Shipbreaker Kraken. Karametra's Acolyte and Agent of Horizons allows me to produce 3 extra mana next turn, which, let's see, 10, 14? I wouldn't be able to play in Monstrous Shipbreaker Kraken anyway. Otherwise, next turn I can play Karametra's Acolyte and Nessie and Asp, which I think is better. See, 3. If I play Nessie and Asp next turn, off of 9 mana. Actually, I will play Karametra's Acolyte and Agent of Horizons. No, I want to discourage the Sealock Monster from attacking. Like, in a bad way. And additionally, if I don't attack with Shipbreaker Kraken ever, except when he's tapped out, I can just Monstrous it and keep these guys both locked down. Because his only removal, well, he has Sea God's Revenge too, which is something I probably should have taken into account. But I can cast both Karametra's Acolyte. And, okay, so I'm not going to block this turn. And Nessie and Asp. Or I could double block. That would definitely allow him to kill my... Nessie and Courser either way. I'm only taking 6 though? Yeah, I can take 6. Oh, you can Monstrous Sealock Monster. That's right. That's right. So I'm actually taking 9. Okay. So I'm guessing he has, what's it called? Sea God's Revenge in hand, which is fine because I can still play some creatures and block with Nessie Enchorser. Even if he does Sea God's Revenge, my, like, biggest dudes. Or he just has bunches and bunches of land. Alright, another Chosen of Heliod, so he's drawing a card. So that goes up to an 8-12. Goodness gracious. Alright, so what we're going to do is chump block. And the reason we're going to do this is because we are playing around Sea God's Revenge by having so many creatures on the board. Okay. My moto is kind of screwy. And if he... well, he doesn't Sea God's Revenge here. Alright, so Horizon Chimera puts us at a distinct advantage because we can flash it in and monstrous... well, we got 2... So our plan basically is to monstrous Shipbreaker Kraken during his begin combat phase. That way, if he has a Sea God's Revenge, he has to use it during his first main phase. So I think what I'm going to do then is play an Agent of Horizons. That way we can still use Karametra's Acolyte to monstrous our creatures. In addition, if he does decide to Sea God's Revenge, or if he Griptides one of our creatures, then we can flash in Horizon Chimera. Let's go. Alright, so during his pre-combat phase, we're going to monster Shipbreaker Kraken. This will tap down these 2 creatures. And there's a good chance he plays another fatty. Or he bounces. But at this point, if he bounces Shipbreaker Kraken, they're still tapped. And we're going to stop during our upkeep and play our Horizon Chimera to take advantage of the life gain. Alright, so he plays another Cap Peg. Alright, so we drew a forest, which we're actually going to play. We're going to attack with our Nessie Nest and our Agent of Fates. And if he doesn't block Nessie Nest, we're going to monster sit. There's a good chance he has Divine Verdict anyway. Which, I'll be honest, it's okay if he isn't using it on Shipbreaker Kraken. That's the reason we're not attacking with Shipbreaker Kraken. It might be a little bit cautious, but Triton Tactics. Oh, that's nutty. So in response to Triton Tactics, I'm actually going to make Agent of Fates unblockable so that it doesn't just die. And we can still Monsters Nessian Asp. It just won't untap during my next untap step. And then Agent of Fates will, Okay, so he wants the Nessian Asp dead. And because of this, I'm going to put the Cavalry Pegasus first, and I'm not going to bother monstrousing my Nessian Asp. The reason for doing this is so that if he attacks with his Sealock monster, I can chump lock with my Karamecha's Acolyte. Actually, I can double block. Yeah. Alright, Wave Crash Triton is a little bit inconvenient. Because if he has something with which to target it, we just die. Alright, so he gets in for one here, which is going to be easily gotten back by the Horizon Chimera. Drawing Time to Feed would be a pretty good one here. I'm gonna take one, because we can't block it. Alright, well, we drew a land, which is fine, it's one life. And we're not going to attack with anything, because we don't want to be blown out by Sea God's Revenge, which would be terrible. And in fact, we probably could have played this land in order to play around that, because we have 8, 9, 10, 11. We need 14. Alright, Nimbus Naiad. That's pretty good. Although if he attacks with it, we still don't die. Unless he taps down this Horizon Chimera. In which case we're just kind of screwed. Okay, God's Willing. That'll do it. So we're just gonna concede. And, a null is actually fine. Although the only thing that we saw was Nimbus Naiad, so we'll just submit. And we'll be on the play, so that's good. Yes. His hand's really slow, but we got a Scryland, so I don't think we mulligan this. Land, it goes to the bottom. So not a land, and that's very good. We'll put it on top. It's also very slow, but this deck, our opponent's deck, seems to be slow as well. Alright, Griptide, we're getting there. Alright, we're gonna play Nihilus Emissary. Because he hasn't played anything either. So we're definitely winning the race. And we're at a pink pig count of 2. For those of you at home wondering. And he didn't play land. Which means that it might be most efficient to just Griptide the Wingsteed Rider right now. And that will hopefully keep him off land for another turn. And basically we're just playing the tempo game right now. Alright, you cast that Wingsteed Rider. Alright, so. Going to attack. And you're playing Nessie Nasp, because next turn we can Monstrous it. And it has reach. Alright, so Aqueous Form going on the Wingsteed Rider, which is annoying because, you know, can't kill it that way. But also, that encourages him to attack. Which is fine. If he plays another creature here, we're just going to Curse of Swine for 2. And you put a card on the bottom. Alright, Voyaging Satyr. That's pretty good. Here, I'm just going to attack with both my guys. If he has a Triton Tactics, that's both bad and good. Because he wasted on our Nihilus Emissary, because that's the only thing that he could kill with it. Alright, told you, Triton Tactics. Called it. And if he blocks our Nessie Nasp, then we just Monstrous it. Or think that something's up. Since he's not killing Nessie and Asp, I kind of want to just pass priority here. Because he could God's willing it. Alright, so no, he didn't. Alright, so at this point, I think we just pig for 1. Alright, so he did have God's Willing. Well, that's good. There goes that removal. And there's our Griptide. So now we're racing. Good deal. Alright, so we're just gonna play this. Although he is at 11, so I mean that's good. There's hope. Alright, Nimisnad, coming down as a creature. Although, oh yeah, the aqueous form fell off. Yes! I mean, yeah, yes. We're going to attack with Annihilia's Emissary. And he's going to block with a Nimisnad. Interesting. Okay. Since he did that, he obviously wants to race. I could play Nemesis of Mortals. Which is a 5/5. Then. Yeah, I think that's what I'm gonna do. Which is another thing that he has to worry about. And then that way I can leave my Nessian Asp back. Alright, Traveling Philosopher, you got it. Alright, so I have enough mana to either Monstrous Nessian Asp or Monstrous Nemesis Immortals. And he kind of has to block Nemesis Immortals, doesn't he? Oh, I could have. Or he's gonna bounce it. Alright, you got it. And I'm not going to, I'm not going to Monstrous either of them. Because if he has a Griptide or another bounce spell, I'm just dead. And so he's not attacking with Wingsteed Rider, which makes me think he has Divine Verdict. He has to do something this turn. Otherwise, he's just dead. Okay, Sealock Monster. Alright. Leaf Crown Dryad. Let's see. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to attack with both of these. I'm going to attack with both of these. If he doesn't block either, he's dead. Alright. Yeah. So he has to block both. And he's tapped out. And I will Monstrous the Nessian Asp no matter what. And I'm probably slow rolling the hell out of this. No, I'm not. Because the only, if I had attacked all out, I would have had to use the Voyaging Satyr. I wouldn't have been able to use the Voyaging Satyr to Monstrous the Nemesis of Worlds. That's the reason. There we go, that's my reasoning. And I think we just hold on to this leaf brown dryad. So yeah, and this way we got both of his creatures rather than not getting either. Yeah, and we just won. So yay, hooray, we did it. So that was a Theros Swiss draft. I'm sorry that we didn't get to see it, the deck in action to its entirety, but we did get to win an extra pack with the Popper 2-man. So thanks for watching.